Now to the art world's most famous whodunit. Works by the mystery street artist Banksy sell for tens of millions of dollars, boosted by speculation about his identity. But now a series of court cases, including one launched this week in Australia, could change everything.
He's the shadowy, subversive street artist who's become an international man of mystery.
The story is an astonishing one, isn't it?
I'd love to get on the trail and find out who Banksy really is.
The unknown artist who'll don a hazmat suit and spray paint the London Underground. Then stun the art world by shredding his own artwork seconds after it sells at auction. Banksy, with his satirical stencils and art pieces that pack a political punch, is one of the world's most influential people, according to Time magazine, but also one of the most elusive.
It was here in Bristol, Banksy's home city, that the mysterious street art suddenly started appearing in the 1980s. At the time, the question was asked, who's behind the work? Now, decades on, we still don't know. Banksy's identity, a closely guarded secret.
Now that secret is being put to the test. After watching art galleries, auction houses and big businesses all profit from his art, Banksy is trying to lay claim to his work legally. The catch is, while he owns copyright, he can't enforce it, according to trademark lawyer Aaron Wood, without revealing who he is.
He's never sued anyone for copyright infringement, and there's a really good reason why. If he went to court and said, I want to sue you for copyright infringement, he would have to say, I'm the person who created it.
Instead, Banksy has applied for trademarks, including two in Australia, a new battleground for Banksy. Mr. Wood is acting for a greeting card company that wants to keep using his art. It wants the Australian trademarks declared invalid, just like they've been in Europe.
We've so far had six decisions out of the seven that we started. All six of those were wins, complete wins, with costs against Banksy. Banksy's yet to pay those costs. We might even take action to bankrupt him.
If Banksy does unmask himself, he could make millions from copyright, but it could also cost him dearly.
If people knew who he was, his artworks probably wouldn't be worth as much.
So how important is anonymity?
Here we have an artist, the world's most famous unknown artist, and people are desperate to find out who he is and who done it.
Professor Paul Goff has written two books on Banksy and says the power of his public appeal lies in his secrecy.
If Banksy was unmasked, would that ruin it?
I think you'd lose something really about the mystique of what he's doing, why he's doing it. And it would still take away something that people think they want to know, but actually they're better not knowing.
And he seems to be caught in this gap of trying to protect his identity versus protect his artwork, and it seems like a bit of a catch-22.
So protecting his identity is interesting. He's what he's saying, as many artists would say, is look at the work, look at the message, hear the message, decide what you make of that message. You don't need to know about me.
After decades of gifting his work to communities from Bristol to Melbourne, London to LA, even donating pieces like this one that raised $30 million for UK hospitals.
Sold. Well done. Congratulations.
It is perhaps unusual that Banksy has decided now's the time to fight for his legal rights.
But people are going to great lengths to profit from Banksy's fame. This is one of several walls that have been removed after a Banksy mural suddenly appeared on it. Property owners are selling the works to art galleries or private collectors. In this case, the Banksy artwork was valued at more than the house.
The piece, titled Achu, was cut from the side of the house just weeks after its discovery.
I think it's outrageous that people buy the wall and sell what is a piece of public artwork given to a town or a city. It's a bit like domesticating a wild animal. You take it from where its habitat works for it and then put it behind bars. And then what's worse, you put it behind a paywall and people have to pay to see a piece, a fragment of a wall.
It's no doubt infuriating for an artist so passionately against commercialism. But is it enough to drive Banksy to out himself?
Maybe like Iron Man. It will turn out he's actually Robert Downey Jr. I don't know.
Is he a Scarlet Pimpernel? Is he a Robin Hood? Or is he just some kind of hoodie who's just struck lucky?
For now, the theories remain.
And my theory is, thank God he's there. Someone once asked me, they said, how much is that artwork on the side of that wall? How much is it worth? And I said, you know what? It's worth a member of the public queuing up for an hour in order to get a selfie in front of it. That's what it's worth.
And the challenge to Banksy's trademark application is with Australia's Federal Circuit Court. No hearing date has yet been set.